Okay, let's get this meeting going here. Time is 7:00. And you will see the agenda. This is a special meeting. We're not changing anything, right?
Correct.
Okay. Has everyone received the minutes of the last meeting? And if you have you noticed any errors, omissions, or corrections today?
God, it's so long.
If not, we'll hear a motion.
Possibly remember.
That they be approved as written.
I move that they be approved as written.
Thank you. Second by... Okay, well...
I mean, I was...
They were good, so you second. Okay, all in favor say aye. So...
Aye.
Okay, permits issued since the last meeting. I'm going around. And Stan, did Stan leave us anything on the... Anything new on the fire protection?
Nothing new.
Nothing new there? Okay. And the primary meeting tonight to decide what we're gonna do on the Savage Paley subdivision bond. And... That was, dated from August 14th from Andy Savage of Savage Construction. A letter to Jamie and members of the board. I'm writing to request an extension of the insurance bond relating to Sharon Road number 2, owned by Kim Savage Realty, KSR. Due to the economy, the 30-acre parcel has not been sold. KSR has kept up the bond and hopes the board would extend the term for at least one more year. What is the board's wishes on that?
I move we grant the extension of the Kim Savage, to the Kim Savage Realty Company of the bond for Sharon Road number 2 for 1 year.
You heard Betsy's motion. Do we hear a second?
I second that.
Any further discussion? If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
So move. Okay. Jamie, did you notify it to that?
Yeah, I wanna talk to you the bond again, because we did get a letter asking about the status.
Yes, we did, yep.
Yep, can I just try and put all together?
Yep.
And that concludes old business. The new business this evening is the 40 Jackson Hill Road. I think you're all familiar with that property up there. And...
Which one's that, Mark?
That's the former convent.
Oh, the convent, you're...
And owned by DePretis and company, or his wife. Okay, what do they wanna change?
They'll come before us formally, because there may be changes to the actual site plan that we approved. We approved a site plan and the use under a resting convalescent home use, and it was for alcohol rehabilitation, high-end. The applicant anticipates that this is going to be more like an Alzheimer's disease and other dementia facilities. I don't see where else you would put it under, but under resting convalescent, that the use would be the same, and that would just be transferred to it. What I told him was, if that's acceptable to the commission, is that he would only need to return then if he changed the actual site plan.
Right, right.
The uses will be the same.
As far as I'm concerned, it would come under the resting convalescent home category.
It just would be long-term instead of short-term, as far as patients. I mean, they were talking about relatively short-term patients, right? This would be long-term.
Which probably would fit more under the resting convalescent than anything else.
Exactly, probably less traffic and what have you.
Yeah.
And since patients wouldn't know whether they're any visitors or not, then probably wouldn't be in visits.
Sadly.
Sadly. Not making a joke of it, I'm just saying, be less traffic. Okay, if that's the consensus of the commission, then Jamie should go ahead and notify them of our thoughts.
Okay.
Okay. And Jamie, since you're on the agenda, any other comments or last questions in the last couple of months?
No, busy.
No.
No?
No.
Wonderful. Anybody make a motion to adjourn the meeting?
Vote to adjourn.